Hi, welcome to Flights of Fancy Storytime. I'm Anne from the National Air and Space Museum, and I'm here to bring some of our museum stories to you. Today, I'm thinking about the moon. It's been a long time since people have visited the moon. At the museum, we have many things that were used by astronauts on the moon, including a lunar landing vehicle. We sent people to land on the moon 6 times. At each visit, the astronauts didn't stay very long, and they used the lunar landing vehicle as their home on the moon while they were there. In this picture, you can see the astronauts climbing down the ladder to take photographs, gather rock samples, plant flags, and explore the moon. There are plans to go back to the moon in a big rocket. The rocket will send a spacecraft that can orbit and also can land on the moon again. We can use a rocket like this to build a spaceport on the moon where people could stay longer and study the moon, but also use it as a place to jump off to other planets like Mars. Here's a story about that. Once upon a time, there were 3 friends who loved adventures, tea parties, and learning about space travel. They were Millie, Ruth, and Lou. One day, at their tea party, Ruth told the friends that she had gotten a new pet hamster. "You have to come and meet her. I named her Rocket. She's so cute." "We picked her up from the pet store yesterday," said Ruth. "Rocket? What a good name for her," said Lou. "Let's go visit after we finish our tea," said Millie. "I bet Mo would like to meet her too." Then Lou started talking about rockets. "You know, speaking of rockets, I heard there's a plan to launch a big rocket that could go all the way to the moon and take stuff that could be used to build a spaceport there," said Lou. Ruth said, "A spaceport? Would that be a place where people could live on the moon?" "Yes," said Millie excitedly. "Maybe they could even jump from the spaceport at the moon to Mars or even further planets." "Hmm," said Ruth. "Would the spaceport orbit around the moon or be on the surface?" Lou said, "I think it would make sense to orbit. Then it would be easier to get to Mars." Millie said, "Maybe it would be good to be on the moon too. There might be stuff in the rocks on the moon that people could use for energy or something like that." Ruth said, "Maybe this spaceport would be both on the moon and orbiting too." Millie looked up and saw the faint outline of the moon in the sky. She pointed up to it. "Look, there's the moon. Wouldn't it be amazing to travel all the way to the moon? I'd like to be one of the people who builds the spaceport on the moon." The friends all looked up at the moon for a moment, dreaming of building a spaceport on the dusty surface. Ruth said, "Okay, go get Mo and come meet Rocket." "We'll be right over," said Millie. "I can't wait, so cute," said Lou, and she jumped up and down and clapped her hands with excitement. So the friends and Mo met at Ruth's house. Ruth picked up a small wired cage with a handle on top. "This is the cage we brought her home in. It has everything she needs, a water bottle, a little food dish, and a cozy cave to hide in." "Where is she?" "Rocket," said Lou, peering into the cage. Just then, a tiny little face peeked out of the cave. She wiggled her whiskers and sniffed the air. "Whoa," said Mo, "so tiny." "Yeah, like the size of one of Barkley's paws," said Millie. Rocket came out and ran all around the cage and then drank a little water from her water bottle. Ruth said, "I think she would like a larger cage. We bought this one, but it has to be put together." Ruth pointed to a big box in the corner of the room. The picture showed a big cage with plastic tubes that ran along the outside of the cage and could connect to different modules. There were ramps to climb up and a wheel to run on. "We can do it together," said Lou, starting to open the box. "You know, this kind of reminds me of a spaceport," said Millie. "If you lived on the moon or Mars, you might have tunnels like this to get from one building to another, since there's not air to breathe outside." Millie pulled the plastic tunnels out of the box. She snapped them together. "True," said Ruth. "And you need water and food supplies, just like Rocket. We're building a spaceport for Rocket, the hamster astronaut." In no time, the 3 friends and Mo were working together to assemble Rocket's new home and make it just right for her. In addition to food and water places, it had plenty of space to explore, cozy corners to hide in, bedding to sleep in and dig in, and a cave for nesting and shelter. When it was finished, they connected the small cage to the bigger one so Rocket could go in whenever she liked. Lou said, "I think we should make a rocket for Rocket." Ruth said, "Hamsters like to run through and chew on cardboard tubes. I've been saving tubes for her. we can each make her a rocket, and then I can replace them when she chews it up. I just want to make sure we use materials that are okay for her to chew. She doesn't eat it, she just cuts through it with her teeth. You can use flour and water as a paste to glue parts on. They all got busy making rockets. I'm adding a cardboard nose cone to my rocket and fins on the bottom, said Lou. I'm going to put a round window near the top. I think Rocket might like to look out, said Millie. Or climb out, said Mo. They all looked at Rocket, who was exploring the ramps and corners of her new home. Ruth put one of the rockets in the cage, and Rocket climbed inside. Mo started a countdown, and they all joined together. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, blast off, Rocket! It's craft time! Zoom! Today we're gonna make rockets that are made out of cardboard tubes and paper. So all you need for this activity is a cardboard tube. And here I used a half of a paper towel tube, but you could use a whole paper towel tube or a toilet paper tube for this. And then you're gonna need some colored paper and your scissors. Now, we want to make sure that all of our materials are really safe and non-toxic in case maybe we wanted to use our rockets to decorate a hamster cage like in our story. So in order to make sure, we're pretty sure that the cardboard tubes are okay. They are just plain cardboard, but we might be worried about any dyes that might be in the paper. So I'm gonna take the paper that I'm thinking about using, take a little piece of that paper, a little strip of that paper, and test it by putting it in some water. And if I just dip that into some water and take a look and make sure that the colors are not running changing the color of the water. And if that just stays the same and doesn't run into it, then it should be safe for our hamster. So it looks okay. So that's good. We're gonna use this green paper, and this will be a really fun paper to use for this project. Now, the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna cut a nice window into our paper towel roll for our rocket astronauts. And so to do that, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna squeeze the tube a little bit, and then I can make a little cut in the tube with my scissors. So I'm gonna cut into the tube with my scissors, just like this, and another cut to make it a little diamond shaped hole. And now maybe I wanna make that hole a round hole. So if I wanna make it round to make it a little bit easier for my astronaut to stick their face out, I'm going to just go back in with my scissors and round that off a little bit. And I can do that just by snipping around. And there we go, the top part is rounded, and then I'm gonna do the bottom part too, where it's still a little pointy. So go back in and take my scissors and go right around that. Terrific. There we go. Now that's a great hole, and you see I've made a hole on the other side. So this would be good lying down or standing up, and you can your astronaut can look out the window either side. Now the next thing I might wanna do for my rocket is put some fins on the rocket. My other one, I put some cardboard fins. This one, I think I'm gonna try making some fins out of paper. So I like to use a triangle. So again, if I take my rectangle and I cut that right through the diagonal, then I get two triangles. And those will be great fins for my rocket. Now to attach these to the rocket, we don't wanna use any tape for this project. So what we're gonna do is we're going to put a little slot right here on our fin. I'll show you, I'm just gonna cut that right here. Perfect. And then cut a little slot wherever you would like to have the fins, maybe right here, cut a little slot. And then we're going to slide those two slots together and slide that right up And there we go. That will hold that fin in place. That looks pretty cool. Let's do another one on the other side. So we'll put the slot right here on our rocket. And then we'll put the slot right here on our fin. And then slide it up so that it attaches together. Well, that looks pretty good. You can kind of push them around till they look the way you like them to do. There we go. Now, that's a great rocket so far, but I think it would really be great if it had a nose cone on top. So for that, I'm gonna take a piece of paper, and I like to use a square piece of paper for my nose cone. And then what I do is I just bend the corner to the middle, and it's already starting to make kind of a cone shape here at the top. This is gonna be the top of the cone, and I bend the other side around, and then I hold it like this and just kind of spin it until it tightens up a little bit and makes a nice pointy shape at the top. Now to make that, keep its shape really well, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna unfold it, and then I'm gonna roll it the other way one time and spin it around and make it really pointy at the top. Great. Now I have it spun around two times, and I'm gonna put it back the other way, the way it was first. And I think now that I've done that, it'll kind of hold its shape a little bit better. Yeah, it kind of stays in a cone shape. So then I'm just gonna take that and I'm gonna slide it into the top of the circles of the cardboard tube. I have to make it a little smaller to fit. Great. There we go. And then the tension from the tube will just hold it in place. It's a little bit crooked. There we go. I'll straighten it up. That looks better. That looks like a pretty good rocket. Let's blast it off. Are you ready? We have two rockets. Now we can blast both of them off in T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Blast off! Zoom! I hope you have fun with this activity. Try it out and enjoy it. And if you like our videos and our craft times and story times, please like and subscribe, and then you'll find them every month as we post them. Thanks a lot for coming and joining us. Bye-bye.